Hey, what's up guys, it's Yvonne, and in this video I want to show you how to create a Microsoft Ads campaign from start to finish in 2024, made in 2024. As you can see, today is January 19th, 2024, which means everything I'm going to show you in this video will be totally updated and current for the new year. So this is what you will see as well if you try to create your own Microsoft Ads account and try to create a campaign in this year. I have been using Microsoft Ads for the past 7 years, which helped me generate hundreds of thousands of dollars with various affiliate marketing products on ClickBank, Digistore, Max Bounty. And in this video, I want to show you how to create a profitable campaign and share some of my own pieces of experience with you along the way. Before we get into it, guys, don't forget to hit like and subscribe and hit the notification bell icon so that you get notified when upcoming videos come out. And make sure you guys stay through to the end of the video so that you don't miss anything important, because like I said, I will be sharing bits and pieces of my own experience throughout the video that you don't want to miss, all right? Are you ready? Let's get straight into it. So the first thing you guys want to do is head over to ads.microsoft.com and either enter your email here and log in if you already have an account, or just click on sign up now and follow the process. It's really simple to create your own account. You can even call them and they are always willing to help. You can call them, you can get on live chat support with them as well, I believe, and you should be able to create your account. Very simple. Once you do, you will see a screen that looks something like this. This hasn't changed too much from 2023. However, there are some small things that have been changed that will be seen in this video throughout our campaign creation process. So for the purpose of this video, we're going to be promoting my website here, YvonneMehta.com, where I offer a free affiliate marketing guide. If you guys are interested, check it out yourselves. But we are going to, so once you're in your Microsoft Ads dashboard, you're just going to go ahead and click on create. And then you're going to see this little new screen that was not there last year. So you might not have conversion tracking set up yet. So we can go ahead and click on skip. And then you can select your campaign type. Now, just a note, if you do have conversion tracking set up, I do suggest you go with generate leads or drive conversions. But this is later. I will make a video on how to set up conversion tracking in an upcoming video. For now, what I suggest we do is we go with search, because this is the lowest hanging fruit. What a search campaign is when somebody types something into Microsoft or Bing search, this is where your ad is going to show up. So really, really useful, really cool stuff. So we're gonna go with search ads here. We're gonna click on continue. And then we're gonna go through the steps here, go through the motions. So the first thing here we're gonna do is enter our campaign name, Yvonne Mehta website, let's say free guide. Let's say that that's our campaign name for our reference later on. If you have campaigns that you set up before, you can use campaign settings from another campaign so you don't have to pre-fill in all the information. We don't, right? Assuming this is a brand new account, so we're just gonna keep that off. You can set your budget, whatever you're most comfortable with. $30 is okay. The more you spend, obviously, the faster you will get results. If you have no idea what to set as your budget, take a look at my video where I share with you how to set your budget, the ultimate guide to budget setting for Google and Microsoft Ads. They would both be the same, both be applicable. The next thing here you wanna do is select your location. So you can come over here and type in whatever you want. Let's say America and click enter, and there's no America, so just type in United States instead. Click enter, then you can target it. You can say Canada, target, and then that's what you have over here. But then we can also say, for example, Australia, and boom. We wanna target these three, for example. And now one thing you do want to do is you want to deselect this option here, because we want to target people in this location, right? We don't want to target people that are searching for United States. We want to target people that live in the United States. So it's very important that you guys select this stop option over here and you deselect the bottom one. Next here we have the languages. Now this doesn't translate your ads. This is just saying, who are you going to show your ads to? People who speak what language? So in this case, English, because we're going to be writing our ads in English. So obviously we want to show our ads to English speakers, right? So we're going to select English here. We can keep everything else as off. That's totally fine. These are more advanced things that I can get into in other videos. Or if you check out my courses at YvonneMehta.com/old-courses, I do cover it there as well. Everything in more detail. So the next thing here we have to do is set up ad groups. So we're gonna enter our website URL here, just so Microsoft can scan our site and give suggestions, so we can do it that way. And then we can hit enter and we can see what suggestions Microsoft Ads will give us. And so here are some things that Microsoft found to be related to my site. What you could also do is you can just enter something here, like for example, affiliate marketing guide, and click enter. And then you would get suggestions related to the guide instead of the site. So we'll give it a second to load. And then we'll probably want to remove that so that it doesn't conflict. And then over here, it has related stuff to affiliate marketing guide now, right? So you can go ahead and you can take a look and find something that's relevant, free affiliate marketing, learn affiliate marketing, that's probably relevant. However, in this specific case, I do want to make sure the word guide is in there, right? Because I'm offering specifically a guide. So for this ad group, I'm gonna say affiliate marketing guide. And then if I can't find anything on affiliate marketing guide, we can just write our own. We don't have to look it up, so that's fine. So here I'll just say free affiliate marketing guide, affiliate marketing training, affiliate marketing tutorial, affiliate marketing tips, affiliate marketing free guide, for example, affiliate marketing ebook, because all of these keywords are related to what I'm giving on my website, right? So if people type any of these in or anything related to these keywords, that's when my ad is going to show up, and that's exactly what we want. Now, alternatively, I could also create a different ad group, right? I could say add new ad group, and I could add some of these. So for example, let's click enter again, go to where we were. Yeah, so I guess that's the beginning here. And for example, learn affiliate marketing for beginners. So what we can do is we can create a new ad group, and then this one could be learn affiliate marketing for beginners. So it's not so much the focus is on the guide as much as the focus being on learn affiliate marketing for beginners, right? So we can take a look at this and see if there's anything that we don't like that stands out that doesn't make sense. Everything here is okay. I do cover Amazon affiliate marketing a little bit in my guide, so we can do that. So the reason why we want to have different ad groups is because we will be able to create different ads for those different ad groups, right? Because for this one, for example, for the affiliate marketing guide keywords, I want to create an ad that says, get your affiliate marketing guide. But then for this ad group, I want to create an ad that's going to say, learn affiliate marketing for beginners. So as you can see, the language in the ad matters a lot, especially depending on who you're talking to. So this is very important to keep in mind. This is why you want to have different ad groups. The more ad groups you have, the better. And it's just gonna make your ad so much more relevant. It's gonna speak so much better to your audience. Obviously, in this video, I'm not gonna create 20 different ad groups, but I gave you the idea, right? So let's suppose we're happy with these keywords. And by the way, it doesn't say it here, you do have different keyword match types as well that you wanna use. So I'm not gonna go over this into too much detail, but basically you have three. You have the exact match type, which you have these square brackets for. You have phrase match type, where you put these quotation marks around, and then you have broad, where you don't do anything, you just leave it as is. So the exact match type, in short, basically means people have to type in pretty much exactly what this keyword is in this order with the same exact meaning. With the phrase, it's a little bit more loose. People can type these words in any order. They can have words after, before, and your ad will still show up. Or you have broad, where anything that Microsoft deems remotely relevant to this affiliate marketing tutorial, these will make your ad show up. These are keywords that will trigger when somebody types something in Bing.com. If somebody types in affiliate marketing training for me, for example, it's going to trigger this keyword, which I have here, which will then trigger my ad, which we will create shortly. So that's how this works, right? So you have these different levels of specificity, of accuracy, precision, where this is the most exact. You want somebody to type in this pretty much exactly to trigger your ad. This is a bit more loose, and then this is the most loose, okay? So that's basically how it works. So then we're gonna click on save and go to next step. And then here we're gonna create our ads, all right? So the first ad group here is the affiliate marketing tutorial, right? Affiliate marketing tips, affiliate marketing tutorial. I believe this is the affiliate marketing guide one, right? So you can click on create ad, and they only have a responsive search ad now, which is fine. So I'll show you how to work with that. So the first thing we're going to do is enter our website. So www.ivanmana.com. And then here we're going to put the headlines. So for the headlines, for my rule of thumb, for the first headline, I like to add my keywords. So what is this ad about? So this ad is about free affiliate marketing guide. Now you have a maximum of 30 characters per headline, okay, so just keep that in mind. You can say free affiliate marketing guide, you can say affiliate marketing tutorial, for example, affiliate marketing training, you can do that. And then for these ones, I want them to show up in the first position. So I'm gonna pin them to position one, all right, both of those. And then we should be able to see our ad here as a suggestion. It's not really showing up right now, maybe it will once we fill in some more details, but normally you will see your ad here to show you what it looks like. So this is for our first headline. What I also want to do is include a call to action, right? To prompt people to do something. So I'm going to say something like get started now. I could say something like, get your free guide now, or sign up for free now. And then these ones I want to pin in position two, because I don't want them to be in position one, right? So if you don't put anything, then it will be randomized. These could be in position one, two, or three, right? But I want it to be specific. In the first headline, I want something to do with my keyword. In the second headline, I want to do with a call to action. And in the third is like an optional one. So you don't have enough headlines, at least three headlines or pin headlines to each position. So what we're gonna do is we need at least position three. So over here for position three, I like to describe my product. So this is a 55-page affiliate guide. And then this one we can pin to position three. We could add one more, saying something like lots of affiliate information, something like that. And then this can be in position three as well. So there you go. These are our headlines, right? Next we have the description. So this is where you would go into a little bit more detail as to what exactly you do. What is this about? So these are suggestions that Microsoft has given you. And then here are the recommended descriptions. So unlock the secret of marketing, drive more sales. So these are okay. I'm going to, let's say, add these. And I will not set a pin for these because I'm fine with them being anywhere. Okay, so I'm just gonna leave that as is. And then here's our ad, by the way. So here it's at the bottom. You can see what it looks like, right? So free affiliate marketing guide, get started now. You have the description right here. You have the website right there. And then you have the headlines right there, okay? And then that's pretty much it for this responsive search ad. So we're gonna publish this ad, right? Once we're ready with the campaign. And then this is what's gonna show up to people when they type something into Bing. So we can click on save, and you no longer really need to create a variation because all the variations are already included here. So, right? So we have this variation for headline one, we have these variations for headline two. So you no longer need to kind of duplicate the ad set and create different variations. However, what we do want to do is we want to create an ad here. So we're going to copy ad to these ad groups. So we're going to copy ad to, in this case, learn affiliate marketing, or you can just say copy to all other ad groups. Either one's fine. And then what we can do is we can come in here and we can edit the language a little bit, right? So instead of saying free affiliate marketing guide, we can say learn affiliate marketing here. And that's, if it's perfectly, learn how to make money online, for example, right? And then this get your free guide, I mean, it is applicable, but maybe not as much. So you can decide, right? This is up to you to decide if you want to include this get your free guide now here, or if you want to replace it with something like learn these affiliate marketing tips, learn three affiliate marketing tips, things like that. That's up to you to decide. I'm just going to leave it like that. Lots of information to learn, for example. So I'm going to replace that with this one. And then these are okay. I'm going to leave these descriptions. The main thing was to change the headlines to reflect the different ad group, right? With the different keywords. So I'm just showing you guys some of the best practices, right? That can help you make profitable campaigns. This is one of them, is creating different ad groups and different ads that speaks to those different ad groups. All right. And so then once that is done, we're just going to go in and click save. All right. So we have our ads for the different ad groups. We're good to go. You could also add ad extensions, but these are extras. You don't need them to actually create the campaign. But if you do want more detail on how to set them up, how to use them, I do suggest checking out my courses here at ivanmehta.com/all-courses, where I go into much more detail in this Microsoft Ads Mastery course, all right? For the time being, this is more than enough. So we're just gonna scroll down and we're gonna save and go to the next step. So over here, we're just gonna check everything to make sure everything is good. We're gonna check the budget. We're gonna set a bidding strategy where you can either set the enhanced CPC or maximize clicks. If you don't have conversion tracking set up, I suggest you go with these two. And if you want to be more diligent and more conservative with your spend, I suggest you go with maximize clicks and then set a maximum click amount. So I would start with something low, like let's say 15 cents, because you can always increase it. But if you start with something too high, you might expend your budget too fast, right? So you don't want that. So we're gonna start with something low here, and then we're gonna just see how things go. Now, if you do want suggestions, you can click on enhanced CPC, and Microsoft here is gonna tell you that for these keywords, right, with the 30 cent bid or 29 cents, you're gonna get an estimated 21 clicks. So is this good enough for you? Do you want more, right? You can test it, and you can enter, for example, 0.45, and then just see how it goes. So you guys could just use this to get an estimate. However, I suggest going with maximized clicks just so you have more control, because that way Microsoft will generally not spend more than what you said here. So once you're good with all this, you can go on and hit save, and then the campaign's created. So now it's under review. So you can click got it, and then here we see the campaign, right? So you have all these options with which you can edit this campaign here on the left-hand side. If you click on this campaign here, you can see all your ad groups right here by name, right? Which is why we set the name so it's easier for your reference. If you click on any one of them, you'll be able to see the keywords that are added, and you'll be able to see all the ads as well. So again, here on the left-hand side, you can use this to navigate. Now, if you go on keywords, by the way, if you want to change these, right, you can click this. And you can click edit and then change match type. So if you want to change, for example, all your broad, like I suggested, into exact, you would then select from broad to, right, change from broad to exact, you would hit save, and now all the keywords that were broad will now become exact. So that's how you would do that. You can also adjust the bid if you go to settings, and this would be the campaign level settings. You would be able to adjust your budget here and then adjust the bid. So if you want to change that, this is where you would do it. Now, let me show you one more thing here, and that's to do with columns, right? So let me just explain briefly to you what this is. So you have the imper columns, which stands for impressions. And if you click on the little question mark here, Microsoft will tell you exactly what each of these columns mean, right? So basically, impressions is how many times your ad has been seen. Clicks is how many times your ad has been clicked on, right? CTR is clicks divided by impressions. So if you get 10 clicks divided by 100 impressions, that's a 10% CTR. There is no black and white answer as to what is a good CTR, what is a bad CTR, because it depends on your niche, depends on your keywords, depends on your ads. But in general, if you're using broad keywords, by broad, I also mean nothing too specific, no long tail keywords. Long tail keywords are keywords, 3 words or more. If you're using general broad keywords, anywhere from 4 to 6% CTR is actually very good, all right? Average CPC is the cost per click. You have your conversions here. Once you set them up, you have the cost per action, things like that. Now, you can also go into columns here and you can modify columns. So you can decide, okay, I want my CTR to be up a little farther. I want my conversions to be down a little lower, things like that. Or you can add more metrics here. If you want to add the cost per mil, for example, how much you're paying per 1,000 impressions, things like that. You can see all these additional ones here and just click on add. Right now, these video views don't apply to us in our case. We don't have a video, but other things here like ad ID, ad type, or maybe conversions here, all conversions, all conversion rate, conversion revenue, you can go ahead and add them and then save a column set, for example, default, and then hit apply. And then this will be the column that you'll be looking at. So if you come over here, this will be the one. And that is basically it, guys. This is how you create a Microsoft Ads campaign here in 2024 with all the updates and all the changes. I hope this video was helpful for you guys. If you enjoyed this video, I do invite you to check out my YouTube channel as well at youtube.com/YvonneManna, where I have over 500 or so videos at this point, 653, including some shorts, which go over in detail many different aspects of online marketing and help you make money online. All right, so I strongly suggest you check it out, as well as my website if you want to get the free guide and you want to go into more detail on any of these topics. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video. We'll be right back.